So routing, we'll talk about four things: graph abstraction, then we'll talk about distance vector versus link state, Dijkstra's and Welch Manford. Right now it means nothing, none of these. So let's just start with this. First of all, is it routing or routing? Right? Routing. Routing is what they do at football games, and the picks tuffle under the trees and all that, and routing is what we are doing. Routing is what one creates a beveled edge on a table. Have you seen a router? Many people have a router at home. And when you send a corps of infantrymen into full-scale disorganized defeat. So that is what the routing is. So this is routing. Next question is it routing or routing? What is the correct spelling? Well, it depends. It depends whether you're British or American. And that's why the Oxford dictionary is so thicker, you know, than the American English. Because they just use extra letters where none required. Right? Many places. So, the right spelling is routing, at least for us. With that introduction, let's go to graph abstraction. So, from now on, we will look at the networks as a graph. Every node or router is a node in this graph, and there are links which have weights on them, which is somehow related to the cost of the link. What is the cost of the link? Cost of the link would be just the opposite of the speed of the link. So if you have two links, one is 1 megabit and one is 10 megabit, 10 megabit is cheaper, will be considered cheaper because it is better for you. Given the choice, will suddenly take 10 megabit, right? So somehow you make up a cost from the speed, or it could be real cost. You know, it's that you have to pay to AT&T for that link. So anyway, so you make up the cost. Then it becomes a very theoretical problem as to what is the shortest cost path from A to B. All right? So now the rest of this lecture is into that kind of mathematics. It is trying to find the shortest cost path. All right? So here is a link, here is a network, and here are the costs. Now the costs don't have to be symmetrical. So for example, the cost from going to V to X could be different than going from X to V. And in general, they are. For example, when you get a DSL connection, the uplink and the downlinks are always different speeds by design. Okay? So the costs are not the same for uplink and downlink. Downloading 1 megabit is not the same thing as uploading 1 megabit. Uploading 1 megabit is a lot of information, a lot of money. Okay? But and that is an extension that one can do, and we will not go into that extension in this course. So we will assume the symmetric links. And so the links are noted by two nodes. And again, that is a specialization. For example, U and X could be connected by two different links, and we are not going to consider that case here. We are just going to consider one link. So here we have U to V, U to X, V to X, and so on and so forth. These are the links. These are the edges, E. And this is the nodes, N. Six nodes, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 edges. Each edge or link has a cost. So for example, W to Z, cost is 5. And the routing algorithms job is to find the least cost path. And we are limiting it to undirected graphs. Undirected means we are not going to consider where the you can only go one way and not two way. And there are lots of one-way streets, but we will not consider them here. All right, and the cost is same, and not only they are undirected, but also symmetrical. Simple things. So there are two ways to get this information. One is called distance vector, and other is called link state. So two ways. First is that, now here's the thing, before we can find the shortest path, I need to know the complete description of all the nodes and the links in between them. And you need to know, everybody needs to know. But how do you know what is the distance between, what is the link connecting Kansas with whatever city next to that is, right? Kansas has to tell us. right? So the idea is that everybody tells everybody about the links that they are connected to, and then everybody gets the whole picture, and then they do some algorithm to find the shortest path, right? So there are two ways to do it. One is that I could tell the world about my neighbors. So there are 60 people in this room, that is the world. But I have only five people who are just next to me. I could tell the world about five people, and if everybody did that, then everybody will know about everybody, right? Second option is that I could somehow get the information about all 60 people and tell it to these five people. All right, so I could tell about the world to my neighbors. All right, so those are the two options. Tell the world about the neighbors, or tell the neighbors about the world. All right. When I tell to the neighbors about the world, tell the world to the neighbors, tell about the world to the neighbors, then my information is going to be very big. I have to tell about 60 different nodes to five people. Right? So it will be big vectors. So, right, that is called distance vector. On the other hand, when I tell the world about my neighbors, I will just tell about the five links that I have, that is called link state. Understood? So there are two methods, link state and distance vector. Originally we started with distance vector, and now we are moving to link state. Okay, if you look at the old routing algorithms, they were distance vector. The new routing algorithms are link state. And the way to remember them is that the distance vectors are big. Means we are telling about the world to the neighbors, to a small number of people. Whereas the link states are small, we are telling about the small number of people to the world. The traffic is the same, by the way, because if I have to tell 60 people about 5, it is 60 times 5. You know, each vector is 5 long, and then 60 messages have to be sent. Or if I have to tell about 60 people to 5, you know, it's almost similar, but there is a difference at the end, as we'll see. Question.
How do you get all the people to send
them? Well, so how do you want 60 people? Basically, the way it happens is somehow, you know, when the network is started, there are only two of us, and we knew each other, and then the third person came in, then I tell them about the two people we have. And slowly, so basically that somehow when somebody comes in or goes out, then we already know the world, right? Most of the time. All right. So those are the two methods. So this is used in the older protocol called RIP. RIP is Routing Information Protocol. And the new routing protocol is called OSPF, Open Link State, whatever. So these are the two we will talk about. And there are two algorithms. Now, this was a very interesting topic for the mathematicians in computer science. And so Dijkstra, well-known guy, he invented an algorithm for shortest path, and that is called Dijkstra's algorithm. And again, this has to be listened very carefully, because this is in the homework, of course, but this is always in the exam. In the exam, if we have an exam on routing, we have to ask for Dijkstra's algorithm. And the next one. All right, so listen carefully. So our goal is to find the least cost path, right? And the notation is that each link has a cost from I to J, Cij, and dk is the total path cost from S to K. All right, S is not given. When we say dk, which means the cost, total cost to K, and S is basically me, source. N prime is the set of nodes for which the least cost path is known. So if we have 60 people, I may not know the least cost path to all 60, I may know only 5 or 3 or 7. Those are in N prime. So in the beginning, N prime is just me. All Okay, and I had to stop here because I should put the word you here, cast from you, because me, I am you. Okay, I am you, so right now I know the cast only from myself to me, to myself, and then I know the cast to my neighbors, because five people I have paid for that link, so I know the cast from me to all my neighbors, and we repeat it, until I know the cast to everybody. First, right now, I don't know the cast to everybody. I know myself, I know the cast to my neighbors, but I don't know whether that is the shortest path or not. And so right now, my set of known nodes includes only me. So how we add somebody to that set? We find out what is the minimum among the known next hops. Okay? And whoever is the minimum that comes inside this set, n prime, and the cast table is changed. So first I start with myself. I know the cast to myself is zero. So I am in the set. But then I have five neighbors. Then I find out what is the cast to the first neighbor, two. Second neighbor, one. Third neighbor, five, seven, three. So the minimum is one. So then the one comes into the known set. So I know that there's no possibility of getting anywhere without going through him. Of the part that we know. And then now that I have put him into the set, now we have two node sets, we will to find out how can we get out of this set. So I have to find out at that set n prime, yeah. So let's do it in a tabular form. Basically, the best way to do this is in a tabular form. We start with the first row. On the first row, we write down zero hops away from me is you. And then we write down the cast to everybody that we know. So the cast to V from U is 2. So we write down the number 2. And the path to V would be U dash V. We'll just go like that. Cast to W is 5. And the path would be UW. Cast to X is 1. And the path is UX. Cast to Y is infinity, we don't know. And the path, we don't know. Cast to Z, we don't know, and the path, we don't know. First row, everybody can write the first row? All right, once you can write the first row, then we find out the minimum in this row. Minimum cast is? 1. So we take that one in the set. So now we put X into the set. And that one is, now we will not write any more here, anything. We know how to get to X. There is no better way possible. Now we see, if we know U and X, how can we get to V? All right? So now the cast to V, if I go through X, it is 3. If I go directly, it is 2. Right? So I write down the cast is 2 and the path is UV, direct. For W, if I go this way, it is 5. If I go that way, it is 5. So we UXW. UXW, you're right. So we can get 4. So we say the cast is 4 and the path is UXW. And then we have to skip X and we go to Y. We can get to Y by X and the cast is 2, UXY. Z we cannot get right now, so we leave it there. What is the minimum along this set? There are two minimums. Either we take V or we take Y. Right? It doesn't matter. You can take either one first and then the next one will come in the next line. So let's say we arbitrarily selected Y to come into this set. All right? So everybody knows how to write the second line, second row. So once you write the second row, now you can put the Y in the set. Now we do the same thing, U, X, and Y, and we can U, X, and Y. These are the three nodes in our set. Can we get to V? Yeah, we can get to V, 3 or 2. So we leave it 2 here. W, U, X, and Y, we can get to W by this method. 3, cost becomes 3. And the path becomes U, X, Y, W. And then we leave X and Y, and then we go to Z. Now we can get to Z, and the cost is 4, U, X, Y, Z. So everybody knows how to write this row number, which is labeled 2 here. Right? Okay. Keep going like that. So now, what is the minimum? Obviously, the minimum is V. So we just put V into this set, U, X, Y, V. U, X, Y, V. These four are in the set. Now, we don't have to worry about these four. We just have to worry about the remaining thing, which are only two, W and Z. So how can we get to W from this set? Well, you calculate all possible ways, and actually you just have to calculate with respect to whatever the new thing came in. So the new came in V, so let's see, that method would be 5, and so that doesn't decrease anything, so that doesn't change anything. So basically 3 remains the cost, and the path remains the same for Z. Now we have U, X, W, V for Z. We don't know still, because we don't know cost to W, we know cost to W, U, V, X, Y. So basically, this will remain 4 because W is not still in the set. So anyway, now the minimum is 4. Once the W, so 3 comes in, W comes in, and then the Z comes in. So anyway, so these red numbers are what the shortest path are. Shortest path to X is UX. Shortest path to Y is UXY. Shortest path to V is UV. Shortest path to W is UXYW, and so on. Make sure that you understand this. I can do it all over again. All right? Because this is one of the key things in networking. Let me start one more time, just to be sure. First, we start with 0 half paths. This is 1 half path, there are 2 half paths, there are 3 half paths, 4 halves, and so on and so forth. In 0 half paths, only thing we know ourselves, U. Right? Now, I'm calculating all the shortest path from U. I could give you the same problem as a homework and say, please calculate all the paths from X. Right? Then you will have to do the same thing. You will put X in the set and write down the cost to all its neighbors. Then find out the smallest one there, put that into the set and write down the cost. Then find the smallest in there, and so on and so forth. Yeah.
If you have two paths of the same length, like time for the smallest, you have to do both of them, or you just pick one?
You can just pick one. It doesn't matter. So let's see if there was a case. For example, here, this doesn't happen to be the shortest path, but this is 5 and this is 5. Right? U to W. You could have taken any one. It just so happened that 1 to 4 is cheaper. I mean, 1 UXB is 4. So we took 4 in this example. But if this was not there, this link was not there, then we would have taken either one.